Good evening. First tonight, a disappointing blow in Victoria's battle against the Delta outbreak. This morning, health authorities were celebrating a return to zero new cases, but hopes of a donut day have been dashed. This afternoon, the Department of Health confirmed it is investigating a confirmed case of COVID. Annie Kearney joins us live now. Annie, what do we know about this new infection?
Just a few minutes ago, Jen, the Department of Health confirmed this new case is a teacher at Altaqua College in Truganina in the western suburbs. The school has sent out a letter to teachers and students and their families saying that everyone and all their household contacts now immediately need to get tested and isolate. At the moment, we don't yet know how this teacher contracted the virus, so that is obviously a big concern. Now, this college was at the centre of our second wave last year, coincidentally. There is also a new exposure site in the western suburbs, Coles Yarraville. Anyone who was there last Thursday between 4:30 and 5:30 now immediately also needs to get tested and isolate, as it is a tier 2 site. Now, obviously, because details are still so scarce at the moment, we don't yet know what this means in terms of restrictions. Authorities had said we're on track to ease next week, and obviously this morning it seemed like things were going swimmingly with no new local cases or new cases in hotel quarantine. It was short-lived, sweet relief, a week after Victoria's fifth lockdown.
It's a brief moment of, of quiet satisfaction, because now we move on and say, well, how do we then sustain that?
But the donut day of zero cases was broken late this afternoon when the Department of Health confirmed it's investigating a confirmed case. Fewer than 3,000 close contacts remain in isolation. More than 30,000 Victorians were tested yesterday and 17,000 were jabbed.
Supply continues to be the limiting factor, not hesitancy or even complacency here in Victoria.
The state government is looking at opening up state hubs for under 60s to get the AstraZeneca vaccine.
We are actively considering that at the moment, and we think we'll have more to say on that in coming weeks.
It's a long way from where the state was on this day last year, recording 439 new cases and 11 deaths. While the worst of this latest outbreak seems to be behind Victoria, pandemic restrictions are still having an effect. The city's New Year's Eve fireworks are again under threat.
But we are working on a number of scenarios. Some of those involve fireworks and some of them don't, depending on the restrictions.
The Lord Mayor says the more people who get vaccinated, the bigger and better Victoria's events can be. Annie Kearney for 10 News First.